Good morning all. This is Hiren Galiwala from Ahmedabad University, India, presenting a work on person retrieval in surveillance video using height, color and gender. As a part of challenge on semantic person retrieval in surveillance using soft biometrics. This is the typical outline of the presentation. We'll start with the basic introduction and lead you to the present problem and the possible solutions with proposed approach. And lastly, we will discuss the experimental results. Surveillance systems are deployed in the society for the security. And many of the cities and countries are now equipped with such a system. It is difficult to identify the person using face from this surveillance footage due to its low quality and the distance between the camera and the person. So in such scenarios, we require some other kind of attributes from the human, such as height, cloth color, gender, to identify the person. And such kind of attributes are typically known as soft biometrics. And generally, people are described using such attributes, for example, a tall male with black t-shirt and blue jeans. The advantage over here for the soft biometrics are like they can be extract from the low quality surveillance video. Also, they can be extract from the distance in the video footage without cooperation of the subject. The previous approaches are having some of the problems with respect to bounding box. Like bounding box with clutter background may impact the person retrieval accuracy. As you can see in the image, like for example, torso is region is detected shown with yellow lines, and yellow circles covers the background pixels. So if your video quality is very poor or low quality surveillance footage are analyzed, then such pixels impact the identification accuracy based on torso color. Also, generally the person height is estimated based on the bounding box top and the bottom, which is indicated with the yellow dot. But actually the person in the image is not covered with such dots. So we need to find out exact height and feet point in the bounding box. So height estimation also will be incorrect if we consider only the bounding box boundary. Such problems can be resolved with a semantic segmentation within the bounding box of the. So it removes the unwanted background clutter. Also, the better estimates of the real world height can be possible. It also helps to extract the precise patch from the torso for color classification. Also, we are using height as one of the filter to filter out the person in upright and sitting position. We are looking for the upright, that is standing person, and they can be filtered from the surveillance frame using height estimation. This is the proposed approach diagram, where initially the person are detected using mask RCNN, where the mask RCNN gives the output for all the person detection with its semantic segmentation and the bounding box. Here all the soft biometric traits, that is height, color and gender, are used in a form of filtering. Initially the persons detected from the mask RCNN are given in the height filter, and all the person heights are estimated using head and feet point detected. Only the person remains in the frame which matches with the query height class. So as you can see in the first row last image, only two persons are remaining where they matches with the query. After the height filtering, the next filter will be the color, that is torso color filter. As you can see from the red circle, the precise torso patch is extracted using the semantic boundary around the person, where Y1 line and Y2 line are from the 20% and the 50% from the top of the bounding box respectively. And ABCD indicated as a region which is the patch extraction to identify the torso color. After extracting the patch, the color is classified using the color model which is trained on different color patches. For example, let's say in the after color classification in the frame, there are two persons with the same height and the same torso color, and one is male and female. Then the further filtering can be done by gender filter. That's how the search space is reduced down using this linear filter approach, where it uses height, torso color, and the gender of the person as a soft biometrics. For experimentation, AVSS Challenge Semantic Soft Biometric dataset is used. It contains the 6 surveillance camera footage which are located in the security network of Queensland University. They also provide the TSI camera calibration parameters which helps to estimate the person height using head and feet point. Total 110 training subjects are given and 41 testing subjects are given for the experimentation. Persons are also annotated with 9 body markers in each frame with 16 soft biometric traits, out of which this algorithm uses person height, torso color, and gender. Each frame has a resolution of 704x576. These are 6 typical frames samples from the surveillance footage of the dataset, and 9 body markers are shown on the left of the screen, where head point, 2 neck point, 2 shoulder point, 2 waist point, and 2 feet points are annotated. The implementation details are shown now. The person is detected with semantic segmentation using Mask RCNN, which is pre-trained on Microsoft COCO dataset. We also use the dataset augmentation to increase the richness or to increase the dataset size for the training of the model. Horizontal and vertical flip, also rotation with -5 to 5 degrees of angle, and brightness is increased with the gamma factor of 1.5 to deal with the illumination changes. Height is estimated using camera calibration process, while color and gender are classified using deep learning techniques, where AlexNet is used, which is pre-trained on ImageNet dataset for color and gender models. These are the details for the color model training, where 1704 color patches are divided into 12 cultured colors which are provided in the dataset. Also, we extract some of the additional patches from the body markers which are given in the dataset. This dataset was augmented using the brightness with gamma factor of 1.5, which can be helped to deal with the illumination changes. So approximately 17,000 color patches are generated, and AlexNet model is fine-tuned, that is, last 4 layers are fine-tuned with 30 epochs, learning rate 0.001, dropout was set 2.5, and batch size was 128. Validation accuracy for color model found was 71.2%. The gender model is trained on 105,980 images with same 80% training and 20% validation ratio, and this time AlexNet was fine-tuned last 3 layers with 20 epochs and batch size of 64, learning rate 0.0001, and dropout rate is 0.4. validation accuracy is 68% for the gender model. Now let's look at the detailed experimentation results, which uses height, color, and gender as a soft biometrics. As you can see on the left side image, where 2 persons are sitting and only 1 person in the standing position. So this can be easily filtered out using height filter. So here the on the right side, the person is in the bounding box which is detected only using the height query, which is 170 to 190 centimeter. These results shows the output, that is person retrieval, using height and torso color both, where middle image shows the bounding box around the person which are matching with the same height query, and the last image on the right side shows the only person which is having the torso color pink. Here all three queries are useful. As you can see on the third image, where the person with the same torso color and height are in the bounding box, but out of these two person, one is female and another is male. So that female can be further filtered out or retrieved using a gender model. So last image shows the female with height 130 to 160 centimeter, torso color as black and gender as female. These are some of the incorrect classification cases, where first image, as you can see with the down red arrow, the person of interest with pink torso color, but as you can see, person is with back pose and the torso is mostly covered by her brownish hair, so color was detected as a brown color. That's how she was misclassified. Second image shows a person with the occlusion, that two persons are detected as a single person using mask RCNN. So here we are getting only single bounding box. So in such cases, the retrieval is failed. In third scenario, where two persons are detected and both persons with the same height class and same torso color and the same gender also. In such cases, how we can resolve the identification, that will show in the next slide. In the last image, the person is detection itself is failed due to very low illumination and low resolution, which is shown with the red circle. As we discussed previously, here two person with the same height, same torso color and same gender, they can be further filtered out using the lake color query. Here lake color was given in the query was blue, and if we implement such a way that out of these two, only single person has been retrieved. Along with the qualitative result, now quantitative results are derived in terms of true positive rate, which is nothing but the number of frames with the correct retrieval divided by total number of frames. And another parameter is intersection over union, where D represents the bounding box output of the algorithm and GT represents the ground truth bounding box given in the data set. So out of 41 test subjects, 28 persons are correctly retrieved, and out of 28, 20 persons are retrieved with greater than 60% of true positive rate, 4% with 30 to 60%. And 4% with 30 less than 30%. Average IOU for the overall system is 0.3905, and IOU greater than 0.4, that 56.70% of the frames have IOU greater than 0.4. The graph shows over here only for those 28% which are detected correctly. Blue line indicates the TP rate for that person and red bar indicate the IOU for that person. So here the use of semantic segmentation allows better height estimation that will filter out the person at the initial stage. Also we can extract the precise color pairs from the torso that leads to correct color classification. Algorithm achieves IOU of 0.3905 and 56.70% of frames is having IOU greater than 0.4. We would like to acknowledge Board of Research in Nuclear Science India for giving us a generous grant to carry out this research. Also, we would like to thank Queensland University of Technology for creating such a challenging data set. Also, we acknowledge the NVIDIA for providing GPU for training the model and testing. These are some of the references listed. Thanks for listening us. Thank you so much.